Blackstone presents Crazy Horse, 3rd edition, The Strange Man of the Oglalas, by Mary Sandoz. This book is read by Bernadette Dunne. All charts, diagrams, and photographs that appear in the print edition of this book can be found in the bonus PDF file that accompanies your audiobook CD or download. Introduction by Vine Deloria Jr. A classic book in the publishing industry usually means longevity in sales and positive reviews in the right places. Often, a title has a prolonged shelf life simply because it covers a topic on which few writers are willing and able to devote their time and energy. Other times, a book deserving benign neglect is embraced by an authority in the field because it promotes his or her personal point of view, and thus preempts better, more thoughtful work. It is a classic in the sense that it becomes immune to criticism because of its sponsor. A better criterion might be whether or not people continue to keep the book in their library after the periodic culling of titles and read it again, even if with some irregularity. But perhaps the best description of a classic is a book that can withstand our ignorance about the subject and offer us a continuing dialogue as we age and become more familiar with the topic. I first read Mary Sandoz's Crazy Horse, The Strange Man of the Oglalas, nearly 50 years ago. As a young man, rushing through it on my way to learning all there was to know about the Sioux Indians. It was one of many books available and seemed to tell a good story, but due to my hasty read, it did not impress itself upon me. In retrospect, I understand that I failed to savor the words, sentences, and paragraphs so carefully crafted as a seamless document. At my tender age, they seemed to blend together into a homogeneous mass containing many extraneous details, but difficult to use because of the lack of footnotes. Facts were my quest in those days. At that time, as a callow and ignorant youth, I was a little offended that a non-Sioux had written a biography of one of the legendary personalities of my tribe. Surely, I thought, she could know little of the nuances of meaning that characterize Indian communities. I was suspicious of the sometimes awkward sentences that seemed to parody reservation English and detract from the straight historical narrative I had encountered in other books on Indians. On the whole, I could not see the book as distinguishing itself from other popular histories of the Sioux. Sandoz's background did offer some comfort of her knowledge of the Indians about which she was writing. She lived in the northwest corner of Nebraska, adjacent to the two largest Sioux reservations, and was intimately familiar with the peoples, red and white, who lived in the desolate Sandhills country. There was never a question of her personal credentials, but the social relations between the Indians and the settlers were not always admirable. And like some readers of literature on Indians, I read the book initially against the backdrop of conflict and suspicion that I had experienced growing up in the area. Yet I had to admit that prejudice had increased since Sandoz's time, and the intermixing of red and white, as she describes it in the book, had been far more positive than what we see today. Rereading the book after nearly 50 years, was as traumatic as my first encounter with the text, but for entirely different reasons. My first response was again to look for footnotes, as scene after familiar scene unfolded in my mind. Surely I had read many of these things before, but where? I certainly couldn't say I had retained much from my first reading. As each chapter chronicled the story of the Sioux Wars to their tragic conclusion, with the assassination of Crazy Horse, I began to see something entirely different emerging. Mary Sandoz had presented a masterful and wholly authentic account of the struggle for the Northern Plains during the 1850s through the 1870s, in which almost every line rang true.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.